Hi viewers, welcome to the Grammar Channel. Today we are going to learn about the lesson The Lost Child. The Lost Child is the story of a small child who gets lost in a fair. He had gone there with his parents but loses them when he gets engrossed in looking at a roundabout swing. This story highlights the bond of love and affection that the child shares with his parents. Before losing them, he had been demanding different things like sweets, balloons, flowers, swings, and many more. Once he loses them, he is picked up by a stranger. The stranger tries to quieten the child by offering him all those things that he had been demanding from his parents, but the child does not want them anymore. He wants only his parents. The Lost Child story is based on the theme of the close bond that children share with their parents. Here, the child forgets all his desires and longing for his parents when he fails to find them. Everything else loses its significance. The only thing that matters is to be reunited with his parents. Now we move on to the summary, The Lost Child. It was the spring festival celebrated with all grandeur. A huge crowd gathered in the fair. The little child ran with his parents. Yes, he was overjoyed to see the toys in the shops. The little boy wanted all the toys. The fields looked gold with mustard flowering. The dragonflies were fluttering over the mustard flowers. The child tried to catch one of them, but he was called by his mother. He ran happily here and there, picking up petals and enjoying everything that happened there. He heard a sweetmeat seller calling jamuns, rasagullas, barfis, and many more sweets. The sweet shop was greatly decorated with different kinds of sweets. Seeing all these sweets, the child's mouth watered. He heard a flower seller saying, "A garland of Gulmohar." He wanted a garland, but he knew his parents would refuse to buy him that. So he moved on. Then he saw a balloon seller. He had lots of balloons with various colors. He wanted all of the attractions in the stalls, but his parents refused to buy even one single thing. The child then saw a snake charmer playing a flute to a snake. He went near the snake charmer and he saw a merry-go-round and he is overjoyed. Men, women, children were all enjoying a ride on it. The child turned to call his parents to say that he wanted to go on the roundabout, but there was no reply. The child had been lost. He cried profusely. He cried and cried and ran to and fro, but he could not see his parents. There was a big, huge crowd there. A man heard his cry. He lifted him up in his arms. He asked him the names of his parents, but the child only said, "I want my mother, I want my father." The man took the child to the merry-go-round. Then he asked the boy if he would take a balloon. The child sobbed and sobbed. The man asked him if he would like to put a flower garland around his neck. He asked him which sweet he would like to have. The child turned his face. For all the questions asked, there was only one reply, "I want my mother, I want my father." Before separation, the child was very happy and excited at the fair. He was fascinated with all the things that were displayed at the stalls. But after separation, the boy just wanted to be with his parents. He was not at all interested in any of those things in the stalls. In the absence of his parents, these things did not give him any joy. The main theme of this lesson is a child's agony and desperate cry when he is suddenly lost in the crowd, and when he realizes he does not have the warm protection of his parents. Dear viewers, the value that we learn from this lesson, the lost child, is that parents undoubtedly are the most precious. They may not fulfill all the demands of a child, but it does not mean that they are not well wishers. If they say no, then it has a reason behind it. In this story, the lost child, we saw the child goes on demanding one thing or the other, but his parents did not give him anything. When he is lost, he cries to go back to his parents, which clearly shows that parents have the greatest value in the eyes of their children. They love their parents unconditionally.